Recording. Okay. So children, term one successfully completed. Even the exam correction, everything is over. You will get your marks very soon, children. So let us think about the term two portions. Okay. We have another main topics that is needed to be covered before the term two examination. That is the first one is subject to verb agreement. I know that this topic is a familiar topic for you children, right? You know what are the agreement or how to fix an agreement between subject and verb. So before starting subject to verb agreement, let me ask you a question. What is a subject in English grammar? You should know the use of subject in English grammar. Tell me. What is a subject? How can you define a subject in English
grammar? The doer of the action.
Excellent. The subject is actually the doer of an action, right? And what are predicates, children? Predicate is once we remove the subject from the sentence, the part which has a verb in us is said to be the predicate part of your sentence, right? So predicate is a part with a verb. And after removing the subject, the part with the verb is said to be the predicate of a sentence. Clear? Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, verb and subject. Okay, to make sure if you want to speak good English, if you want to make sure that you are writing a very beautiful English, you should think about an agreement between the subject and the verb. And the subject-verb agreement is also known as subject-verb concord in English grammar. Okay, subject-verb concord or subject-verb agreement. Always, this verb should agree in number, in person with the subject. Okay, I repeat, a verb should be in an agreement within a sentence with the subject. Verb is completely controlled by the subject in a statement or in a sentence. Suppose there is a basic rule that is coming under the subject verb agreement. As you all know, this action words are always limited and controlled by the subject. That is why these verbs are called finite verbs in English grammar. Clear? Am I clear, children? Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So there should be an agreement between the subject and the verb in a sentence. Let me share the screen. Let us think about subject in general. Look at the first screen for you children. What is a subject? How can I define a subject? Remember, a subject is the person. If it is a subject, it should be a noun or pronoun in English grammar. I repeat, if you are talking about a subject, that should be a noun or a pronoun. And normally in a statement, in a normal sentence, except an interrogative sentence, the subjects can be seen before the verb in the sentence. Okay. Remember, it is positioned before a verb normally in a sentence. I repeat, subject should be a noun or a pronoun. It can be a noun or a pronoun, okay? But at the same time, the position of a subject in a sentence is always at the, normally, not always, except interrogative sentence, the most commonly we use these subjects before the verb in a sentence. Only interrogative sentences, you can see the subject is used after a verb. Okay, so this should be a person or thing that is doing an action, or the person or thing that is the focus of the sentence is said to be the subject of a sentence. Remember my second point, it can be a noun or a pronoun. You can use Nima, you can also use she. Okay, it should be a noun or a pronoun. Table, it. It can be a noun or a pronoun. Okay. Remember the position of a subject most of the times. Okay. The position of the subject is most of the times the beginning of a sentence. Remember, this should be placed before a verb in a sentence. Remember, the position of the subject is most of the times at the beginning of a sentence. These are the three major points that you should keep in your mind. What is a subject? A subject is the person or thing that is doing an action. Point number one. Point number two, the person or thing that is the focus of the sentence. This is point number two. Point number three, it should be or it can be a noun or a pronoun in a sentence. Point number four, the position of the subject is most of the times at the beginning of a sentence. These are the four points that you should keep in your mind when you think about a subject. Okay, Shivanya, what is the subject? Where is it? What is the position? Why it should be a noun or a pronoun? What are the five or four points that you should keep in your mind when you think about subject?
Ma'am, a subject is a person or thing that is doing an action.
Okay.
It is a person or thing that is the main focus of the sentence.
Sure.
It can be a noun or a pronoun.
Okay.
It is normally positioned at the beginning of the sentence.
Okay. Now I have Ashmit here. Ashmit, I'm not sharing. Now you can tell me what is the subject.
I'm a subject is a person or thing that is the doer of an action.
Excellent.
The person or the thing can be the focus of the sentence.
The main focus of the sentence. Good. Point number three.
It can be a noun or pronoun.
Excellent. Point number five.
The position of the subject is mostly at the beginning of the
excellent.
Sentence.
Excellent. Excellent. Very good. Thank you. Thank you. So let us see what is a verb now. So you got the idea of a subject. Let us talk about a verb. As you all know, verbs are the action words in a sentence, right? Verbs are called the action words, and normally that describe what the subject is doing. You can see two pictures here. Here, a girl who is sitting and reading. So this person, the girl, she is sitting and reading. Here, the word reading is a verb in use, right? Because that is the action she does. Okay, again, the boy, he is eating a piece of bone or a piece of chicken piece or whatever it is, is eating meat, right? So eating is the verb. So the action word reading, the action word eating are the words actually done by, or the action done by the subject. Okay, so these are called verbs. Action words are called verbs in English grammar. Now, let us talk about the basic rule or the most important rule coming under the subject verb agreement. The subject verb agreement is also known as subject verb concord. You please write both the headings. I request everybody to write the headings. Subject verb agreement. Subject verb concord. CBSE, under CBSE, it's written subject verb concord. It is not written subject verb agreement. See, C-O-N-C-O-R-D. Okay. So you have two headings.
Can you repeat the spelling?
Yes. Subject verb agreement. Second one, subject verb concord. Both are same. Okay. In future, if you hear concord, please don't get confused. It is equal to subject verb agreement. Okay. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So let us talk about the basic rule. You know, I have told you a few minutes before, I have told you children, this verb is always limited, or it is controlled by the subject in person, number, and also person and number, right? What do you mean by this? A verb is usually limited by the subject. What do you mean by this?
The subject
contains only one subject.
It has a control. Who has a control? The subject has a control over the verb. Because as per the basic rule, children, noted, if your subject is singular, you should use a singular verb after the subject. Okay? And whereas, if the subject is plural, you must use a plural verb after the subject. John is singular in form. So John, singular subject. So John controls the verb likes. Okay, I can use only likes here. I cannot use like after John, as John is singular. By the basic rule, remember, if the subject is singular, we must use a singular verb. Whereas, if the subject is plural, we must use only a plural verb. Subject is plural, so we have to use a plural verb. Am I clear? According to the basic rule, a singular subject takes a singular verb, whereas a plural subject takes a plural verb. That is why John, the singular subject, takes likes, a singular verb. They, the plural subject, takes speak, the plural verb. Okay, so remember, you know, if it is crow, what is the crow is a noun, right? Crow is a noun and this is singular in form. Okay, noun singular. How can I change this noun into its plural form?
Crows.
C-R-O-W-S. Okay, this is plural noun. But here, if you want to change a verb into its singular form, okay, I repeat, if you want to change a verb into its singular form, just the reverse is happening. Singular of the verb should be ending with S, ES or IES form. If the word, see, remember the word singular is starting with the letter S, right? It is starting with the letter S. So usually the verb ends with the letter S. Singular verb, the word singular is starting with the letter S and the verb singular is ending with the letter S. Just opposite. See, noun means we are adding S or ES at the end to make a noun plural. But this just opposite is happening with the verb. If you want to change a verb into singular, the word singular is starting with the letter S. So the verb is also ending with the letter S. Clear? Am I clear? So John likes me. They speak good English. These are the important points. Subject verb concord. The basic rule, a singular subject takes a singular verb. She is a singular subject. It takes a singular verb. Bill is a singular subject. It takes a singular verb. Car is a singular subject and it takes a singular verb. Whereas a plural subject, they takes a plural verb. Plural verb means base form of the verb. Okay, plural, it is in the form of a base form. Not the base form, but it is in the form of a base form. Okay, clear? Am I clear?
Ma'am.
Okay, now let us go into the first one. Look at the slide here. You can see, register this picture in your mind. How many birds are here?
Only one.
So one is equal to singular. More than one is equal to
plural.
So one is equal to singular. More than one is equal to plural. So you can see a bird here, right? You know these sentences, a bird. So I have to use with a bird, the singular subject, because it was starting with the letter S. So a verb should be ending with the letter S. So a bird flies. Okay, with the singular subject, a bird flies. At the same time, with a plural subject, birds fly. Remember, birds fly. With a plural subject, you have to use a plural verb. With the singular subject, you use a singular verb. So a bird flies and birds fly in the sky. Clear? Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. This is with the singular subject. The basic rule says that with the singular subject, you need to use a singular verb. With the plural subject, you have to or you must use a plural verb. See, only I can see Anlia, Alina, Ashmit, Abhishek, and I can see only Midun, Devika.
Ma'am, my video is on.
Neema, Krishnaveni, Vinayak, Tia on the screen. What about others? Steve, what about others? Shivanna, where are you, Shivanya? Shivanya, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
I couldn't find you.
Ma'am, the first one, first one.
Ma'am, first one.
Ma'am, that is
at the first.
No?
Ma'am, the ma'am, other one, the other one, back. Ma'am, in the first set.
Yes, I got it. I'm searching for you. Okay, Ayman. Ayman, Sachin, Ellen, Adnan, Zaiba, Abhinav. Then I have few. Agna Maria, Gino, Abhinav, Tia Tojo, Surya Narayan, Evelyn, Ellen Joy, all these students are requested to switch on your video. So you should switch on your video. What is the use of sitting without switching on your videos in a classroom situation? Okay. Okay. Okay, Agna, granted. Permission granted. Okay. Now, children, listen. I'm going to share my second rule. Okay, this is important. You're familiar with this rule. This is called rule number 2 under subject verb concord or subject verb agreement. If you want to connect two singular subject with a conjunction and, in that case, it requires a plural verb. I repeat, one singular subject is connected with another singular sentence using a conjunction and it requires a plural verb. Okay, because gold ring, silver ring, two different metals, right? Gold is one metal, silver is another type of metal, right? So we are using two different nouns to connect with the help of and the conjunction. There we must consider it has a plural subject and I can use only are, or I can use only where, I can use only have, I cannot use anything else. So it follows a plural verb. I do request everybody to copy two or more singular nouns or pronouns joined by and require a plural verb. So it requires a plural verb, children. He, third person pronoun, I, first person pronoun, two different person pronouns are connected using and. It requires a plural verb, children, because he, that is Steve, I, that is Miss Anju. We two people are standing together and you are going to connect our friendship with and. Steve, Saju and Miss Anju Vimenan are good friends. Okay, so and. So we are getting two different persons, so we have to use a plural verb. Clear? Am I clear? Two nouns, two different singular. I repeat, two singular nouns, if it is connected using a conjunction, yes, and, it requires a plural verb. This is point number 2. Okay, this is rule number 2. And you know that there is an extension to rule number 2, right? This is called 2B, rule number 2B. What does it, Shivanya? Can you recollect it? You covered this topic in 7th standard. Can you recollect this? I've told you, children, this is required for the 9th standard then. Can you recollect rule number 2B, the extension? Can anyone? Rule number 2 says that two singular nouns are connected, or if it is connected with each other using a conjunction called and, it requires a plural subject, sorry, plural verb, right? But rule number 2B says that two singular verbs, if it is, sorry, singular nouns, if it is connected with and, but still it gives us one single idea to my mind or to our mind, it requires a singular verb. Okay, again, the opposite happening. See, children, we have bread and butter. Think, just think about this bread and butter. Rule number 2B, it says that, see here, rule number 2, I said, two or more singular nouns or pronouns joined by and require a plural verb. And I gave you three examples. Gold and silver are precious metal. Fire and water do not agree. He and I were playing, were the examples for you, children. At the same time, look at here, rule number 2B is just an extension to rule number 2. Okay, this is just an extension to rule number 2. I said earlier, two singular nouns are connected with the help of and, it requires a plural verb. But here, that is wrong. Because here, the concept bread and butter, this is said to be a compound noun. Okay, that is, it is used together. We cannot separate. Okay, we cannot separate these nouns. So that we have to consider it has a singular noun and this is followed by a singular verb. Suppose if the sentence is Tom and Jerry is my favorite cartoon. See, I'm not using Tom and Jerry are my favorite cartoon. I said or I used Tom and Jerry is my favorite cartoon. Why I used is here? Why I haven't preferred are there? Because I'm talking about one single cartoon, right? Tom and Jerry is a title. It's the name of a single cartoon, isn't it? But I can say that Tom and Jerry are my favorite cartoon characters. There I have used because I'm thinking it's separate. Tom is one cat, Jerry is another cat. So I'm connecting Tom, the cat, Jerry, the mouse using and. So you can use in the form of Tom and Jerry are my cartoon favorite characters, are my favorite cartoon characters, right? But if I think about Tom and Jerry as a single cartoon, I have to use it as singular in form. So I must use singular verb there. Okay. At the same time, like bread and butter. Try to imagine bread and butter. I have a slice of bread in my hand. I have a bottle of butter just in front of me. I am not taking bread separate, butter separate. Than that, I am just taking a few the butter and I'm going to spread it over or on top of my bread, folding it, I'm eating it, right? Yes or no? So no, so it is actually a single concept. I'm not eating it separate. Suppose if the sentence is rice and curry. Okay, I have a bottle of sambar in front of me. I have a plate of rice in front of me. I'm not going to drink the sambar, right? I have to mix the curry in my rice and I can take it then, right? So this gives one single idea to my mind, rice and curry. These are not separate nouns. These are actually used together. So in this case, we have to use or we must place only a singular verb because these are compound nouns. Am I clear?
Yes.
Okay, so consider these examples. Keep these examples in your mind. Again, the second example is bread and butter. Rise and fall of the tide is due to lunar influence. Rise and fall. It won't stuck there. It has to come down. If I say rise and fall of the tide means the tide won't stuck there for a long time. It has to come down. So it is a normal process of going up and down, right? Up and down. So this is one single compound usage. So you can say that I can use only a singular verb with a singular noun. Am I clear? 2B, the extension is clear for you?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it clear for you, children? So yes, include the examples, rice and curry, rise and fall of the tide, bread and butter. Though these are two different nouns, but this gives one single idea to our mind. So we must use it together and we can consider it as one single one. And we must use only a singular verb over here. Okay. And now comes rule number 3. Under subject to verb.
Can you show the last slide?
Sure. Shall I move to the next slide? Okay, so I'm moving to the next slide. Rule number 3. This is such a wonderful rule, okay? There are a lot of tricky methods to analyze or to get an answer to this rule, okay? See, children. Rule number 3, under subject to verb concord. Okay, that is a singular noun or pronoun is connected with another noun or pronoun. See, one singular noun or one singular pronoun is connected with another singular noun or pronoun by using words like with, as well as besides, together with, no less than, and other similar expressions. The verb should be singular in form. Look at the rule number 3, children. with a singular noun, another noun or pronoun, if it is connected with one another noun or pronoun, using the following expressions like with, as well as, besides, together with, no less than. Here we must use only a singular verb. Okay, we have to use only a singular verb. See, you can see, look at the example. The ship with its articles was burnt down. Somebody called. Who is that? Who called me? No. So let me share the screen once again for you. See, here, just see the pattern. Just see the method for finding your answer, okay? I said one noun is connected with another noun using with, as well as, besides, together with, no less than, other similar expression. It requires a singular verb. See, you can see right from with, after removing. See, once it is given, once it is started writing with the subject, then you can see I have written with its article in brackets, right? It's there within the brackets, right? Yes or no? Yes or no? Not brackets, within the commas.
Yes.
Now agree?
Yes.
Look at my second example, the ship with its crew. Here, with its crew, again within the commas, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So this is known as extension of the subject. Okay, this doesn't have a role in a sentence. If you find a comma after the subject and a few words starting with all other similar expression written on the board, and that is also actually quoted between a commas or two different simple commas, then you can strike the extended words and think about only the subject. Here, after just striking out, just see, I'm just striking out. So here, what remains? The shop remains, right? The shop is singular in form, so that you can use singular verb over here. This extension can be removed. Just strike out. Okay? There is no need for this extension. This is actually not required. It doesn't have a relevance. Okay? This is just an extension to the subject. So we can remove the extension and just think about only the main subject, and you can find that this main subject is singular in form. So we can consider it as singular and can be used as a singular verb. Am I clear? So these words, these extension within comma can be removed. Please don't consider the words within the commas, because these are the extensions to the subject. Okay. Now, yes, look at the second one. Look at the second one. The ship with its crew. Actually, we are talking about the main subject of the sentence is ship. Okay. With its crew is just an extension. We are simply describing what are there within a ship. Okay. This is not required. You can just cut off, or you can just strike it out. You will get only the ship here, and ship is singular in form, and you can use a singular verb with the sentence. Clear? Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, here, there are no commas, but these two singular nouns are connected using as well as the expression, right? Yes or no? So if you find as well as, just think about it. Here also you can use the same method, okay? Here also you can use the same method. Look at the first subject, and you can start cutting from as well as until the verb. And what remains? Silver, singular in form, right? This is singular in form, so you can use is. Again, another word, the same method can be used with the last sentence. The father, the phrase is actually starting with as well as. Cut it out until or near the verb. And what remains? The father remains here, and as well as, his sons removed. So you will get an idea to use only a singular verb. This is a trick. Okay? This is a trick. Okay, so it is time to end my session. So thank you for coming here. We'll explain third rule onwards in the next class. Bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.